come to you to increase our views. Today, we are going to talk about sustainable development issues. As production footage shows, coral bleaching, desertification, and climate change, all of those environmental problems have some influences on tourism production. Of course, on the other hand, those environmental problems are caused by tourism activity to some degree. Therefore, study what is sustainable development and how to use this concept in tourism areas become more and more necessary. So today, we organize a seminar in UQ that those professional tourism area master students give us a thoughtful discussion on sustainable development issues. So, let's go there. That's what we're talking about. Hello everyone.
Hi.
Thank you for you guys coming to this seminar. As we know, sustainable development has been one of the most important issues in the world, especially in the tourism industry. I think this concept has been recognized as a buzzword. Why?
Yeah. Yes.
So Serena, could you please tell us what is sustainable development and also the relationship between sustainable development and the tourism industry?
Sure, my pleasure. Environment topic nowadays became a hot issue that drew people's attention. In 1972, the environment problem was first introduced to the international agenda, and in 1987, the sustainable development was recognized as a definition by the United Nations in the Brundtland Report. And the following definition is one of the well-known the definition of sustainable development. Sustainable development is a development that meets the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. So, finally, in 1992, sustainable development was approved to use as a strategy of the tourism industry. Another definition is that we can say sustainable development is a huge system developing, including enormous society resources and environment cooperation. As we know, under globalization, tourism industry growing up is very rapid. As the global economics predicts that the international tourism industry growing up will remain 3% to 6% annually. At the same time, it cannot be ignored that the rapid tourism industry must depend on the nature and the society environment. However, the planning and interpret activities will lead to the negative impact for the tourism industry, and it will also impact the future generation's resources and needs. And it can form a threat for the tourism industry as well. So, therefore, sustainable development is increasingly very important for the tourism industry. And so, government and the tourism cooperators should utilize this as a guideline for the future developments in tourism industry.
Thank you, Serena. I think you already know what is sustainable development. Now, Tilly, could you please tell us why sustainable development is important for tourism industry?
Okay, sure. For tourism industry, sustainable development is particularly essential. It is true that tourism has contributed to a great deal of benefits, but the fast economic-driven development of tourism industry sometimes will lead to some negative impacts on tourism destination, environment, and communities. As we know, tourism activities strongly rely on the social and natural environment. However, both of them are vulnerable. It is reported that the degradation of natural environment might be the most severe issue currently. Tourism businessmen just aspire to get the most economic revenue from the tourism activities rather than considering the sustainability of ecosystem. Therefore, heaps of environment problems are emerging, like the threats of biodiversity, disruption of coasts, deforestation, water overutilization, climate change, and inequitable resource wasting. On the other hand, social culture has also been influenced by tourism. It can be reflected as four aspects. Firstly, social culture has lost its original values because it has been considered as a piece of commodity to cater for the demands of tourists. Secondly, with the increasing globalized tourists to the cultural heritage sites, traditional cultures has tend to be assimilated. Thirdly, the local community has been in danger of crime occurrence because of the overcapacity of the destination. And lastly, the large amount of tourists crowding in the destination at the particular time will disturb the locals' lives. Accordingly, there's a need to apply the sustainable development to tourism industry because it can solve the contradiction of natural environment protection and the profit maximization. And furthermore, to maintain the diversity of tourism products and contribute to the benefits to locals, sustainable tourism development will orient the right way to the future tourism industry.
Thank you for your job, children. Let's move on next part. Cherry, could you please tell us what kind of impact does sustainable development bring to tourism industry?
Okay, no problem. Sustainable development actually creates like huge impacts on current tourism industry. Basically, it is advanced management concept which can has a great contribution to both tourism destination operation and planning. It also gives tourism operators some new concept. For example, the tourism environment carrying capacity, people call TECC, it helps the supplier understand the relations between environment and the tourism participants. As the expanding of the sustainable development concept in tourism industry, by analyzing the impacts, the impacts can be divided into three main aspects, which are the tourism economy, tourism products, and tourism environment. In the aspect of tourism economy, like by using the sustainable development concept, obviously it will have some negative impact on the short-term economy. Because first, tourism developer or operator will spend more funds and to establish and maintain the operation of the sustainable development, such as the ecological conservation. Also, by consider the tourism environment carrying capacity, the developer will control the number of tourism participants like much stricter. So, however, this will also support to the long-term economic development. On the other hand, it will strongly affect the tourism products. So the tourism products is what the operator provide to the traveler and for creating their the full travel experience. So which including food, accommodation, transportation, tour, entertainment, and shopping. So these six major products like can be affected by the sustainable development in the tourism industry. People try to stop using some products that damage to the environment. For example, the eco-tourism and the low-carbon tourism are getting more and more popular in recent years. Especially low-carbon tourism, like people try to minimize the influence of the tourism facilities and by reducing the carbon emission. Furthermore, there are also big impacts on the tourism environment. In recent year, like many destination operators pay more and more attention on the local environment. The tourism environment actually can be divided into three parts, which is the ecological environment, social environment, and the climate of the destination. In recent year, many destinations try to change and improve the local ecological environment. Those efforts will reduce the speed of species extinction and climate change to some degree in future. Also, the destination operator try to protect the local culture from the foreign cultures. And those efforts will use a lot of resources to complete. It will promote the image of destination, which can bring the long-term benefit to tourism destination.
Well done, Terry. So how to use this concept in tourism industry? Sharon, Could you please tell us some management strategies about sustainable development?
Sure. Here are some management strategies to address the issue of sustainable development. First of all, from government's aspect, firstly, to conserve the environment with regulations and managing the destination with related legislations. Japan, for example, enacted the Basic Environment Law in 1992, right after the Rio Summit. Next, undertake publicity to promote the ecotourism and the green tourism. Improving the overall public awareness of the importance of the environment protection. UK, for instance, launched the Green Tourism Industry Campaign to achieve this goal. Local residents should be well looked after as they are the main force in the destination protection. So government should publish the policies to encourage the corporations to employ and utilize the power of the local residents to better undertake the sustainable development. Additionally, tourist education cannot be overlooked. Take Australia, for example. Tourists here are required to take care of the natural habitats of all kinds of animals. Secondly, from tourism board's aspect, tourism board should pay attention to the overall harmony of the destination, aiming at minimizing the tourism development's impacts on the environment. Before launching a new program, the research about the destination's ecosystem should be undertaken, as any destination's maximum capacity mustn't be exceeded by receiving too many visitors. Next, from the tourism corporation's aspect, firstly, the sustainable development concept entails the production of green tourism products. And then the sustainable development policies should be employed in terms of the internal management and operation, such as the policies of the energy saving policies, the recycling policies, and the environment protection policies as well. Lastly, the non-governmental organizations and the non-profit environment protection organizations also play an important role in the implementing of the sustainable development concept. So a series of actions taken by the volunteers, such as the planting trees, investigating into the endangered species, and the renewing of historic buildings. Good examples are set for not only the communities, but the tourists as well.
Thanks a lot, Sherry. As we mentioned before, sustainable development requires to meet the needs of present and also next generation. This has become more and more important, especially in tourism industry, because the development of tourism industry depends on natural and social environment. At the same time, tourism activities can bring out some influences on those natural and social environments. Therefore, sustainable development should be used in tourism industry. Well, I think it must got some useful point from our discussion. Now it's bring us to the end of our seminar. See you next time.
See you.
It's all about, 'cause baby, half the fun is in us figuring it out.